a good example, and certainly the cross-party leaders meet to me. Lord, I know you've had them in the past, and when we, even with the cabinet system, when we cast online back way back when, we had, I think, what was it, 5-3-2, would we not? With Labour, Conservative, and Liberal in the past. And you could argue whether that worked or not, but, you know, I take it as well, I think the 2008, you could argue that was proposed. You know, depends how you look at it, but I can understand that. There's a lot, I think, there's a lot to play for. And not least, we've all got to go back and talk to our groups and see how our groups feel about this. And you come on now to like hear things, you know, for the first time, you think, well, we didn't agree to this. So I'm sure the members, well, I was still with you, and we need to discuss within our groups, don't we? And come to agreement within our groups. But I think also, as well, if we're talking about whether it's whatever system it is, policy and resources is going to be, is it not, proportionate, yeah? Depends on the outcome of the elections, but, you know, that will be the makeup of the committees, yeah, and the policy and resource committee. So you could argue, it's going to be a party wig on it. So some people outside might say, well, what difference is that then? Yeah, because if somebody has a large majority and they're using the party whip, we're going back, you could argue, to square one. I'm not saying we are, but you could argue that, couldn't you, with that. So the people might say, well, what's the difference to what you've got now? I would go further personally with opening it up, no matter what system it is. I mean, I think personally, if you don't open it up a lot more often, you can talk about it, which I think we have today, and understanding people's views. Why don't we have, for instance, on public resources or public questions on that? Why don't we have a lead members question and answer sessions on social media every so often? That opens it up, makes people more accountable, does it not? And maybe a members question on policy resources, if policy resources turns out to be decision making. Which it isn't in this case, because there's full councils in it. It looks like with this particular one. So there's a lot of issues, in terms of the committees themselves, there's a lot there to be commended for, you know. And I think when we had the LGA meeting with the leaders the other week, Phil, I thought that was very positive. The cross-party members group, and I think we need as well, but again, as I'm sure, we need sort of some form of workshops coming up to inform members more and we get more opinions on board. But there's a lot I think to commend it with to what we've done so far, but we can do a lot more to open up the whole system, and I'd like to think that those things I've just mentioned can be taken on board, because I'd like to think as well there's a different feel this year, and I know what Councillor Green says, and he's right. At the end of the day, we're all politicians. We've all got our own policies, we're all passionate about them, and we'll all fight our corner on the concrete paper. And rightly so, and the public expects no less, and we'll vote accordingly, you know. But I do think a more collegiate approach, and certainly changing that culture, is something that we need to work on as well, to make any system work.
About those things and to reserve to yourself. see the on the proposed, and it is only proposed, as Phil said, there's a work in progress, calling as well as not to step off the potential for what you're watching, but it's all close to a quarter. Once the working group has decided exactly what it wants, and then we will bring a proposal in front of this committee, and then it will be voted upon accordingly. But as I say, we are still.
Well, what is it then? Because Mr. McCulls has said this is the way it's going to go, because he's taking instruction to go down this highly sophisticated calling procedure. That's the way it'll be done. Tony, you're saying that you see it being something different, and there are some sort of hybrid where decisions can go to council. As a member of the council, all I'm interested in, what is it? And I do find, you know, not a nostalgic return to the traditional committee system, that's the expression, wasn't it? You know, I defer that, if we're talking to councillors, a tad patronise it, and actually requires something.
Thank you for that final comment, Jeff. But I'm sure it will be discussed within the groups, and it will say it'll be discussed again within the working
group.
If no one else has got anything to add, I'd like to thank everyone for your attendance. I think there's an absence of any other business, so I'll draw the meeting to a close. Thank you very much for your time.
Yeah.